So today's video is going to be a fun and exciting video, and it's a little bit different than anything I've ever posted on my channel. I'm going to be doing a lip swatch, and I'm going to be doing it on all of the Kylie lip kits. I had a really, really good time filming it, and I hope that the lighting is okay. I'm trying to see on the side here if it's good. It looks a little bright from what I'm seeing, but hopefully you guys are able to see the colors properly. So I'll do the lip swatches first, and then I'll talk a little bit about them. So the first one is Candy K, and this is one of the nudes that I liked the most out of the three, I believe, that I had. I feel like the pencil did glide on perfectly, and the color was perfect. It wasn't too dark, too light. It was like the perfect pinky nude. So I really enjoyed this one. It looks so nice, and you could wear it with pretty much everything. Coco K was probably my least favorite of the bunch. I felt that it was a little too light for my skin tone. I'm sure I can get away with it with the right color eye look, but I felt like it kind of looked a little sloppy on my skin, and it was really hard to get it to like a perfection for me. So this wasn't my favorite, but I think if you have a lighter skin tone than me, it would probably look beautiful. Dolce K was my favorite nude out of the bunch. I felt that it was not too pink, it was not too bright, it was the perfect nude color. It's pretty much the same color as my actual lip color, so I feel like I can wear this as an everyday lip color. I also show you guys that it is transfer proof, so you'll see in a second when I kiss my hand. You can't see it on my hand. Posy K looked so amazing with my skin tone. I feel like this color in particular will look good on any skin tone. It's so beautiful. It's like that perfect spring kind of pink color. It's not too dark. It's not too light. I really enjoyed this one. I think I'll definitely get a lot of wear out of this one. If you know me, you know I love my bright colors, so 22 is my favorite out of all of them. I absolutely love this color. I feel like it's the perfect orangey red. It's not too orange, it's not too red. It's perfect. I cannot wait to wear it all summer long. I absolutely love it. So True Brown K and Court K are the darkest of the bunch. I didn't have Court K at the time because it came out after I filmed this video, but with these two, I did notice that they're a little bit more drying than the other ones. They are also harder to apply because they're so dark. You want to be careful and you want to do it as slow and as precise as possible because they can get a little messy. But other than that, I love this color. It looks so beautiful.
Overall, I think they're so good. I do like the formulation. I have extremely dry lips, and I'm wearing it right now. I can't even feel it on my lips at all. So it's definitely a very thin consistency for all of them. That's the way I feel about all of them in general. They're very thin consistency. You can't really feel them. If you touch your lips, you literally feel like you have nothing on your lips. So that's always a good thing. I do love that about these products. I do have to say the lip liners for each kit are everything. I would probably buy this kit just for the, did I say eyeliners? I meant the lip liners. So the lip liners for this kit, for each kit, is so good. They are so amazing. They glide right on. They literally just, like, you can literally just, it shows right up. You don't need any pressure. Which that could be a good thing and a bad thing, because I feel as though even though they're so easy to apply on your lips, they do go down. I've only used this one once, and I'm not sure if you can see, but it's already basically gone. So you're going to have to sharpen this a lot, and I feel like because you have to sharpen it a lot, the lip pencil is definitely going to go fast, and they don't sell them separately, so if you do need to buy the lip pencil, you would have to buy another liquid lipstick, which, you know, it's kind of annoying. I wish you would sell them separately because that would be amazing. Now, all of these do have a scent. When I first applied these on my lips, when I first got them and I opened them, the scent was so powerful, it almost gave me kind of like a headache. And I'm not a huge fan of vanilla scents as it is. I feel like for some reason they just give me such a bad headache. They make me so nauseous. So I'm not a huge fan of vanilla scents. And I feel like these, all of them, every single color that I have all of them except for Mary Jo K, which is the red color. All of these I feel like have that strong vanilla scent. So if you're not into scent, you might not like these because they're very, very strong scented. I did get used to it after a while. And I feel like once you apply them, you can't really smell it. It's just like that initial, like when you open it and you're applying it, the scent is very, very strong. So definitely be careful if you're not a huge fan of scented products. This does have a very, very strong scent. Overall, the liquid lipsticks, the packaging, I love the packaging. I think it looks so good, especially for it being Kylie Jenner. We know why she's famous, because of her family. And I feel like the Kardashians have their own beauty line at Ulta. But I feel like it wasn't like a luxury brand. I feel like Kylie's stuff looks a little more luxury. It looks like she put a little more time into it. And I feel like the packaging is definitely her to a T. So I love the packaging. I think it's very, very nice. It's very heavy. It feels like it's worth something, you know? So yeah, that's how I feel about them so far. The price for each one is $29. And at first I was like, oh my God, that's kind of a lot. But when you think about it, you're getting a liquid lipstick and a lip liner. So in reality, you're not paying that much. I mean, a MAC lipstick on its own is, I believe, $16 to $18. And their lip liners are right around the same range. So you're almost paying the exact same thing for a MAC lipstick and a MAC lip liner. So it's not that bad, and like I said, those lip liners are bomb, so you need to get them, if only for the lip liners, because they're so good. I honestly really am hoping that she comes out with just lip liners and just liquid lipsticks, like, on their own without the lip kits, because it honestly, they're so good. Like, they're really, really good. So yeah, so my overall reaction for these lip kits, I'm very impressed. I was a little afraid because I wasn't sure what to expect. Everyone was raving about it, but of course they were going to rave about it because it's Kylie Jenner who made them. So I was a little skeptical at first, but I do really like them. But yeah, she did a really good job with these liquid lipsticks, and I'm actually excited to see what other things she has planned because I think she's coming out with more than just lipsticks. So I'm really excited to see what other products she's in the works with, because so far so good. I like them. I am going to give these a thumbs up, and I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I know it was a little bit different than my normal things. I'm trying to expand a little bit and get into other things. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up, and thank you guys so much for watching. I will see you in my next one. Bye.